November cook-off. Problems chef and IPC and flip the stream. So the first one, this is my submission, sorry. Yeah, so we were given these students, N students, and they watched K lectures, okay? So each, how many minutes did they watch each lecture for is given to us. So Tij means I'd student watch J lecture for T minutes. We want to ask this question that will they get a certificate? Now the condition to get a certificate is you must watch at least M minutes. So immediately I thought that, okay, this is a straightforward problem. Let us use a hash map. So for all the students, I'll just store the total time. Okay, that's it. So for all the students, for all the lectures, they're going to give us the input ti, j, right? So I add this to the total time of I. Then at the end, I also take this q. Basically, they have given us one more condition, right? How many times did they make a query? What is the criteria for getting a certificate? Q times. If they made more than 10 times, then don't give it. So if they made a query more than 10 times, make it zero the total. And here you can see that the criteria will be at least one. So when I make it zero, it becomes ineligible for certificate. Now, what do? I just go through all of these guys. And if any of them have watched more than M minutes, I need to give them a certificate. So plus plus the count of certificates and return it in the end. The other problem, flip the string, is kind of a really interesting one. In flip the string, what we need to do is, given two binary strings A and B, you have to make A into B by doing this operation. Select a substring and flip the bits at the odd indices. We just want to do this. Noticing from here how they took this example, they've highlighted the odd indices, right? So basically what we are saying is, we can choose any substring and flip the alternate indices. Why am I saying alternate instead of odd? Because what if I start my substring at the next position? Correct. Should I explain this in deep? I'll just show you my approach. For a deep explanation, you can watch the CodeChef official tutorial. So immediately I realized that between the two strings, I just need to check the odd positions and even positions. Okay, would that be enough? Let's see. What about this test case? Okay, when we look at this test case, what are the odd and even positions? Let's look at the first test case. What are the positions? 1, 0, 0. Those are the odd positions, correct? So I am comparing them. Where's it gone? Here. With 1, 0, 0. And there's no issue with that. It gets compared smoothly. So I've just written this code to see what I'm doing. First, I'm comparing the odd indices, then I'm comparing the even indices. In the first string, as you can see, the first thing that I'm comparing is, first thing that I'm comparing is 100 and 101. Why 100? Because if you notice here, 100 is nothing but 1, 0, 0, all the odd indices. And then what is 101? In the other string, it is 1, 0, 1. Right? So they are not matching. So I'll need to make some change. What about even indices? Again, 0, 0, 1. So as you can see here, 0, 0, 1. And on the other side, I have 1, 1, 1. 1, 1, 1. So again, they're not matching. Now, when something is not matching, can I immediately say that, okay, this is a foul? No, I can't. Why? Look at this case. The last case. Firstly, 1 and 1 both are matching. Then 0 and 1 are not matching. So I'm going to be flipping these. But till where do I flip? I'll flip these two. I'll flip these two. And then here I won't flip them. Right? I won't flip these two, correct? So I'll stop flipping here and I'll add that to my result. And then again, for these two, I'll need to start a new session of flipping. Correct? As you can see, comparing 1000 and 1010. So I don't need to flip anything here. But when you see these two, 0011 and 1110, right? The positions, odd positions, 0011, 1 0011 1 1 1 0. This one was matching, right? This one was causing an issue. So first I'll flip these two. I'm only looking at odd positions, right? So my code was simply first divide into A odd, B odd, A even, B even. Okay, so I've divided both of them into two parts, right? And now I'm just going over those two parts. So as you can see in A odd and B odd, it's a 0, 0 and 1, then a 0 and 1 again, then a 1 and 1, and then a 1 and 0. So how many times will I need to do my flip operation over here? Immediately you can recognize, once I'll do it on this substring, make it 0, 0. Once I'll do it on this substring, make it 1. Correct? So now it kind of becomes like longest non-matching sequence, number of non-matching substrings. This one is matching, so we stop doing anything here and we call it a one operation, and then again at the end we get one operation. So yeah, how many substrings are unequal? Whenever we reach the end or an equal substring, we stop. That was the logic for both the odd substrings. If current is just checking, is there any change right now? Are they not matching? If they're not matching, make current true. Otherwise, they're matching. So if there was some current like non-matching substring before this position, as you can see when comparing these two, why do I keep clicking on that? These 1, 1 are matching, but current will be equal to true from the previous non-matching elements. So add it to the result. Okay, I've added that to the result. That means I flipped it. Now again, what happens is you go, the for loop continues and A odd is not equal to B odd. Nope, they are not equal. See, they are not equal over here, 1 and 0. This equals over. This 1 and 0 are not equal. So now what to do is, after the for loop also you make one check. If changes required is equal to true, then you add one more changes required to the result. Do the same thing for the even part of both the strings. Okay, same exact code. And return the result. Again, for a good explanation, check out the CodeChef official solution. This is just for those, you know, who might have been stuck at this problem for a while and just needed to see a small hint on, oh, that was the implementation. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.